Could we improve the performance of do-it-yourself CNC machines by integrating machine status into the CNC controller? In this video, we'll read the following error from closed-loop stepper motors into the computer running the CNC controller. Other videos in this series will build on this idea. The use of stepper motors on CNC machines is criticized because stepper motors don't require position feedback to their drives. Without position feedback, the CNC machine is assumed to be in the correct location, but it's not actually known. Some say servo motors are better than stepper motors because servo motors have encoders, but the servo motor has an encoder because of an inherent need by the servo drive. Nowadays, closed-loop stepper motors are common, and they have a built-in encoder that the drive uses to monitor the difference between the commanded position and natural position. This is called the following error, and it's the primary variable in the control loop for the closed-loop drive. Our CNC machine is a retrofitted Precision Matthews 25 milling machine. Each axis has a 280-ounce-inch closed-loop Leadshine Easy Servo stepper motor with built-in encoder. These are attached to Leadshine Easy Servo drives, which monitor the following error and respond using both a position and a current control loop. Step and direction pulses are generated for the drives by a Pico Systems Universal Stepper Controller. This board receives velocity commands from LinuxCNC and uses those to generate step and direction pulses. This is much more efficient than sending step and direction pulses directly from the controller. Virtual position error derived from a machine model and a count of the pulses sent is returned to LinuxCNC for its own control loop. A desktop computer running LinuxCNC serves as our CNC controller, and this is where we want to monitor the following error. The Easy Servo drives only report following error from a serial port via a diagnostics protocol. Unfortunately, the diagnostics protocol is not published, so to create interoperability with LinuxCNC, we must first reverse engineer the protocol. This program is an implementation of a reverse engineered protocol, and the program is plotting the following error from the Easy Servo drive connected to the Z axis. As we exercise the axis, you can see the effect on the following error. In addition to every reading of the following error, we're plotting the average and the maximums. The program requests the drive to record following error for 200 milliseconds and then retrieves the values. With a readout overhead of 100 milliseconds, the most recent data is 300 milliseconds delayed. While sampling duration is configurable, 200 values are always returned and the readout overhead is fixed. So we select a sampling duration that's short enough to be near real time, but not too short to be dominated by the readout overhead. The readout overhead is shown by the spaces between the measurements of the following error. Actual position will generally lag commanded position while the machine is in motion, and some amount of following error is realistic. Too little following error, the machine will be stiff and jerky. As the load on the machine is increased, so will the following error. And we can demonstrate this by increasing the load on the head by putting an additional 40 pounds of weight on it. Exposing the following error to a machine operator might help them to optimize the aggressiveness of a machine operation, similar to a spindle load meter, but integrating it into a CNC controller might enable automatic optimization, and that idea is what we're exploring with these videos. From my experiments, I only needed certain commands reverse engineered, and none of the configuration commands were implemented. I also have only tested the software on Leadshine Easy Servo 508 drives, and no other drives are expected to work. The software is available on GitHub with a link in the video description. Like all software on the internet, the best advice would be not to use it at all, but if you do use it, you use it at your own risk. In the next video, we'll look at how the diagnostics protocol was reverse engineered and go through the software. In the third video, we'll integrate this software with LinuxCNC. Thank you for watching, and I always enjoy reading your comments. We'll talk again soon.